My name is Mackenzie Anderson, and as a part of my art history class, I got the opportunity to research some great art, works of art around the city of Fayetteville. And my chosen artwork is Holding On and Letting Go, the Strengths and Struggles of the Salagi, and it's painted by Stacey Bates. Holding On and Letting Go, the Struggles and Strengths of the Salagi portrays the journey of the Cherokee Indians during the Trail of Tears. During the 1830s, the piece of art was commissioned by the city of Fayetteville in order to fill the trail with artwork that served as a remembrance to these people. While the project was underway, the city's finance director, Paul Becker, discovered that the mural did not qualify for the state grant. Luckily, after all the work of going through the selection process, the city staff and members of the Fayetteville Arts Council wanted to see the project through, along with a $5,000 budget. The trail was opened in 2014 and runs parallel to Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard. Stacey Bates, the artist of the mural, wanted to focus her efforts to convey the strength, traditions, and culture of the Cherokee people. Bates, a teacher at Woods Elementary at Fort Smith, was chosen to create the mural out of 40 applicants. Bates remarks that a lot of research and planning went into beginning this project because she wanted to portray this entire group of people accurately and to do them justice. The history and symbolism of the artwork was held paramount within the course of the project because a lot of people who journey along the trail do not typically know the history of the area. Bates draws most of her inspiration and creativity from her art students. Being able to show her students that art is a viable career path is very important to her and her career. The nationalistic value of this mural is part of why it has become so popular with the local people of Northwest Arkansas. Because of the rich culture of the indigenous peoples of this area, this trail is a local landmark that provides Northwestern Arkansas with the information of the people that has once dominated these lands. While this piece of art is not symmetrical, it does provide an equilibrium from its asymmetrical balance that is very satisfying to see. The rectangular patterns in the background help to evoke feelings of reliability, stability, and symmetry. The pattern serves to provide an evenness to the mural, but also a slight form of monotony in order for the patterns in the foreground to catch the eye and stand out. The lines and details used on the hands within the mural help to provide the eye with texture. The implied texture of the hands could also symbolize the trials and tribulations of the Cherokee people during their heart-wrenching journey. By painting the feathers, rough hands, and basket-weaved background, these images provide a sense to what the artist was trying to convey in an emotional, romanticized way. The intensity of the colors used in the mural evokes a sense of happiness or hope because of the bright yellows and oranges used in the mural. The methodology used in this painting would be biographical. The golden eagle feather used in the mural represents something sacred and precious to the Cherokee people. When combined with sticks, the feathers were used to make wands that were used in the special dances and ceremonies, like the eagle dance. The eagle dance is one of the most significant events within the Cherokee tribe, where they would pay respects to the life of an eagle before hunting it. By displaying the golden eagle feathers, Bates accomplished her goal of focusing her efforts of highlighting the history of the Cherokee. Because of Bates' effort to display integral aspects of the Cherokee culture, the mural truly focuses on the strengths and rich history of the Cherokee people. The hands of the Cherokee Indian, tightly grasping to the symbols of their culture, juxtaposes the meaning behind the mural in the first place. They were being forced from their lands, so the Cherokee people's massive efforts to preserve their rich culture proved to be quite a challenge. The Cherokee people worked hard to protect their customs, and in a lot of ways they succeeded to do so. This piece of artwork is highly influenced by the post-impressionism of the late 19th century. The edges are defined by sharp color separations and are relatively clear. The vivid colors used within the mural and the distinct lines and brushstrokes of the painting lend a hand toward this area of art. And even beyond that, the emotional content explored through this mural reflects ideas derivative of the great artists during this movement. Being a new resident of Fayetteville, I really had no idea what was around me, so I really appreciate the opportunity to be able to go out to this new city and explore. Being able to learn about the Cherokee Indians and their history has really brought something to me that I really appreciate because I've never really gotten the chance to do that. Light to this piece of artwork is something that I think Stacey Bates was really just trying to portray through her art.